Welcome back, everyone. It's the Bourbon Judge. We have a guest judge back with us again.
Hey, Bourbon Judge fans. So good to see you all today.
It's been a long time, Cousin Nita.
I know. It's been a minute. You know, it's hard out here in these streets. So just trying to keep up, cuz.
I know. It's all my everyone who watches the channel, like, what happened to Cousin Nita? Where is she? You know, is she like on a remote island?
Thank you.
What'd you do with her? So look, it's proof she's still around. She is still around, folks.
trying to hang in there. So great to be back.
Why don't you give everyone a quick update on what's new with Cousin Anita?
So I have stepped into the realm of teaching. I am now an instructor at Cincinnati State. Mm-hmm. So I'm excited about that. Marketing 101 and Marketing 115. So an intro to marketing and market research course.
Professor Anita.
Exactly.
No more Cousin Anita.
I'm hoping to recruit a few more Bourbon Judge fans.
All right. We'll see.
Yeah, I might need to hang on to the job, though. Be at the job a little bit before I start introducing my students to the world of bourbon. So we'll see, Bourbon Judge fans. We'll see. Yeah, so that's the most exciting news right now. And just glad to be hanging out with this guy.
Good. Well, we are happy to have you back. And, you know, it's actually perfect timing because I know, like you, like mm-hmm. myself and Mrs. Mm-hmm. Judge, we love Costco. So Kirkland this year came out with the new version of their bourbon, right?
Wow,
they sourced it this year via 1792, Barton mm-hmm. 1792, mm-hmm. a Kentucky-based distillery. Mm-hmm. So they sourced it. And so we're here to review primarily the single barrel, which just came out like literally a week ago, actually, here in Delaware.
Right.
A week ago here in Delaware.
Well, you know I appreciate bourbon on a budget, right?
Yeah, right.
So, because we got to get the bills paid and still enjoy ourselves. So
indeed.
Right on Costco.
Indeed. So these were like, this was like a limited release, you know, mm-hmm. at least for this year. Who mm-hmm. knows whether or not, like, later in the year or in 2022, if they'll again partner with 1792,
okay.
will it be, you know, the same type of, you know, small batch, bottle and bond, and a single barrel? Like, exactly what will they do? So, you know, the first two got, I mean, they were really, really good. And I was like, you know, I want to do the single barrel. New Cousin Nita was coming in town. I was like, you might as well go ahead and have you help review us. All right? Review it with us. So I've already reviewed these two, so I'm going to hold off. Plus, no lie, Bourbon Judge had way too much bourbon last night.
Indeed.
I had way too much. See, she's a bad influence on me. We'll blame Cousin Nita, not my hand, drinking the bourbon. So I've already reviewed the small batch and the bottle and bond, but mm-hmm. It's called the Cliff Notes version. Mm-hmm. So this year they, again, partnered with 1792. Mm-hmm. They created three different drops. The small batch, which comes in right at 92 proof. The bottle and bond, which is, of course, is age at least 4 years by 1792, coming in at 100 proof.
Okay.
And then most recently, the single barrel, which is 120 proof.
I'm going to
let you guys see that bottle. Okay. See that? There's the front. And I'm going to let you guys see the back. There you go. You guys got it? All right. So I've already reviewed the small batch. So
okay.
$20, $25, $30.
Oh.
And these are for liters.
I know. Jackpot.
Right? So $20 to $30 for a liter of bourbon, and good bourbon typically?
I love it.
So
I love it.
I'm going to let you try of our pour.
Okay.
This in order, the small batch. Let me know what your thoughts are on the small batch.
All right.
So 92 proof.
Mm, it smells yummy.
It is. I'm not even going to say what I think you'll get. We'll let you be the judge of that.
Whoa, that's super smooth.
It is, right? Very nice and elegant. Mm-hmm. It's very peaceful bourbon.
It is.
Goes down very nice.
It is. And you know I love a small batch.
Correct.
So I don't know if I've told the Bourbon Judge fans mm-hmm. about my favorite, but mm-hmm. I'm a really simple person,
mm-hmm.
not as sophisticated as this one over here when it comes to bourbon.
Please.
But as I started drinking bourbon, I was introduced to Four Roses. That was one of the first bourbons I was introduced to.
Mm-hmm. Love it, Four Roses.
And so my favorite all day, every day, has been the Four Roses small batch.
Sure, yep.
And
nothing wrong with that.
Again, you all know I've mentioned mm-hmm. a little bit on the sweeter side.
Yep, absolutely.
A little bit lower proof,
mm-hmm.
And really smooth. So, not that they are identical, but there are some similarities
there
definitely,
for sure.
Small
Absolutely.
Batch.
Absolutely.
So the smoothness is there. the caramel, fruitier notes, fruitier the notes. Caramel.
Yep. Did you get any bananas at all in that?
Not too much on my palate. Okay. But that was very nice. Nice. Okay. Yeah, that was lovely. That was lovely.
It's because you need like the small batch.
And I'm really like wanting to say it's like 5-star because it's $20.
So true.
I'm like it's $20, so it's the best bourbon I've ever had.
You can't beat it. I mean, a liter for $20 is not bad. Not bad at all. All right. I want you to move over to the bottled and bond, okay. And I would love to know the differences between the two. So this one comes in, again, at 100 proof.
Okay.
Again, still made by Barton, 1792, so that's the middle glass.
Yeah.
Let me know what you're thinking about that bottled and bond. Ooh, this will be interesting. See if she likes this one just as much, equal, or maybe she doesn't like it as much. Who knows?
Now, this one I do get a little bit more spice, just a hint more spice than fruit in that. Not too heavy, but just a bit more.
All right.
Still the same kind of color profile, right? Yep, so very absolutely. Similar there.
Very similar from a color standpoint.
Oh.
Wow, leaving her speechless. You like that? Whenever she does that, whoa.
So this one? The crazy thing is, like, it's doing the dance on my tongue.
Okay.
Dance and a little like bit.
You like that?
And I like
it. What was different between the bottled and bond and small batch, in your opinion?
You know, so it marinates a little bit more.
Okay.
Still smooth, but this might be a tad smoother.
Really? I found this one to have a lot more, because this is so, it's a smaller batch, a lower proof, it's very elegant and soft and peaceful.
Yeah.
This is a bit more well-rounded compared to that one. For me personally, on my palate when I had it, kind of going off memory here, but I remember like a lot more like banana notes, some more caramel, a bit more vanilla, a bit more just well-rounded as a whole.
And I would say for me, this one finishes well. So I didn't notice so much of the flavor profile when I took my first sip.
Okay.
But this one starts really well, if that makes sense.
It does. So going it down really traditionally.
So it really kind of starts well too. Ooh my. Okay.
Good.
That was good.
Good.
I mean, they're both really good, but I'm surprised that I'm leaning a little bit more towards
the bottom bond. All right.
Yeah. So let's see.
All right. It is time now for the single barrel. All right. Coming in at 120 proof. Let's rock and roll.
All right. Cheers.
Cheers.
Okay. All right.
Ooh. That is delicious.
That's good too. I was going to say, doggone it, that's
a $30 bottle at Costco.
That's a winner too. Ooh.
To me, I love this.
Now, I knew you were going to go for that though, because that has a little bit more strength.
It does. Right? Yep. 120 proof.
You like a little bit more kick, so I can definitely feel that. Absolutely. But even though it's a higher proof, it again is not that, you know.
It's a long finish, but it's a consistent finish. It's not as bold and as flavorful as a 1792 full proof, right? Different proof point. You know, the full proof is not always a single barrel, right? So it's different, but it's not as bold as a 1792 full proof. It's a bit more, probably, I would say, across the board, like the palate is a bit more manageable. The full proof really hits you.
This one
it hits you, but it's not like at least for me, it's not a Mike Tyson like knockout.
I feel it a little more than the previous two, but that makes sense, right? It's a higher proof. And so traditionally you're probably gonna feel that
absolutely
a little bit more, but definitely nice.
Very nice.
Not too crazy.
Not crazy at all.
And I'm still kind of blown away by the price points, to be quite honest with you, because
the nose is actually very similar to the bottle and bond.
Yes.
Tons of like caramel, tons of bananas, some notes of like tobacco on there. Some pepper. Wow.
They did a really nice job.
Got a little bit left in the glass. Might as well go ahead and kill this, right?
you need to step your game up, because Cousin Anita
you had three.
Made it happen.
To my one. that to me is a solid choice all day long.
To me, I'm
as I try to do and be a nicer, softer, more gentle bourbon judge in 2021, I'm gonna let you give the verdict on the single barrel. Is this worth a buy? Is it worth hunting? Is it worth going to that Costco or finding a Costco? At $30, your judgment is
so
in?
So, my judgment is, it is definitely a buy.
Absolutely.
I would say, again, from the price point standpoint, as well as the smoothness of it, just a great flavor profile overall. I'm just really shocked. Yeah. I'm really shocked.
Great
that,
nose.
Yeah.
Great
yeah.
palate and a yeah. great long consistent finish, so, but not too bitey.
Yeah. So definitely what I imagine is going to start happening since these all sold out really quickly. Mm-hmm. I think Costco will get them in over the holidays.
You think so?
Because you know they love to stock up on hot sellers
so
during
true.
The holiday season.
So, so true.
I would tell Bourbon Judge fans to be on the lookout as
Again.
We really start to into the heavier
holiday
like Christmas
season.
Time. Yeah.
Be on the lookout. That's Cousin Nita's prediction.
Yeah.
You never know.
Yeah.
Well,
yeah.
I will say, you know, funny story about this one. I need to give a quick story. So we were on vacation with the family. We went to the Outer Banks. Of course, this comes out.
And Cousin Anita wasn't invited. But a story for another day.
Next year.
I promise.
We went to the Outer Banks, coming home, and I get a note from one of my friends I kind of met through the whole bourbon world.
Uh-huh.
He's like, my man Ronnie, by the way. So Ronnie, huge shout out to my man Ronnie. Ronnie's hey man, you know, the Costco, they just released the Kirkland bourbon. He's like, it's almost sold out.
Uh-huh.
And I'm like, oh my gosh, I'm driving home from the Outer Banks. What am I going to do, right? I got to get a bottle. I need to complete the trilogy, right? So my man Ronnie's like, hey, Bourbon Judge, I got you. I got a bottle for you. We'll meet up one day. So we actually met up. I truly only got this because my man Ronnie, we met up he got me a bottle. I gave him the cash. And
I want to say thank you, Rodney, because as a general rule, we do not want to promote bourbon drinkers ditching their families on vacation to pick up bourbon. Just so we're all clear, that's my PSA for the day. Yeah, they probably won't go well.
So true.
Go well with your family.
So true. I tried driving home a little faster just to get there, but it wasn't fast enough. I was like, Ronnie, hook me up, man. So he hooked me up. So shout out to you, Ronnie. I appreciate you.
Goodness.
And as I say with every review, I do need, before we end, three quick favors.
Mm-hmm.
Number one, hit the like button. Number two, drop me a comment. I love going back and forth. It's my favorite thing.
Yeah.
And last but not least, please make sure you guys also hit the subscribe button.
And I just want to say have a great holiday weekend. It's
Absolutely.
Always good to be back with the Bourbon Judge
Indeed.
And the Bourbon Judge fans. We love you all.
Indeed.
Thank you so much for supporting
for
my
sure.
dear cousin. It's good to see you all.
Absolutely. Peace, cheers, salute. Take care, everyone.
Take care, guys.
Later.